Hello everybody, I am Dr. Mohammad Chakraborty. I welcome all of you to this intellectual property course. Today's lecture will be on patent. A patent is a form of intellectual property that gives its owner the legal right to exclude others from making, using or selling an invention for a limited period of years in exchange for publishing and enabling public disclosure of the invention. Let us look at the different IP strategies. First, you have to identify intellectual property assets. Then, develop a plan of protection through four major forms of intellectual property, that is copyright, patent, trademark, and trade secret. Next, you have to exploit intellectual property through program of licensing and distribution that best preserves your IP position. After that, develop program of enforcement of intellectual property rights. Monitor changes in the law and participate in such changes. Watch for IP claims by key competitors, particularly in the patent area. What is a patent? A patent is a right to exclude others from making, using, offering for sale, selling, importing the patented invention. It is not a right to use the invention. Quid pro quo means this for that. In the case of patents, the exchange is that you disclose to the patent office and therefore to the public the great invention that you have made or are working on. It is valid for 20 years from date of filing. There are four different types of patent. Number one is the utility patent. It's a long technical document that teaches the public how to use a new machine, process, or system. New technologies like genetic engineering and internet-driven software are challenging the boundaries of what kinds of inventions can receive utility patent protection. Next, we come to provisional patent. United States law allows inventors to file a less formal document that proves the inventor was in possession of the invention and had adequately figured out how to make the invention work. Once that is on file, the invention is patent pending. If, however, the inventor fails to file a formal utility patent within a year from filing the provisional patent, he or she will lose this filing date. Next comes design patent. This patent offers protection for an ornamental design on a useful item. The shape of a bottle or the design of a shoe, for example, can be protected by a design patent. Last but not the least comes plant patent. Just what it sounds like, a plant patent protects new kinds of plants produced by cuttings or other non-sexual means. Plant patents generally do not cover genetically modified organisms and focus more on conventional horticulture. There is a common misperception that patents inhibit free exchange of information. On the contrary, the patent laws require disclosure of the structure of the invention, how to make and use it, and the best mode of the invention. Patent applications are typically published 18 months after filing and in any event upon issue. An applicant is free to disclose the invention anytime after the application is filed without jeopardizing patentability. A patent right is not a right to perform the invention, a monopoly in the marketplace. What can be patented? As we have learned in the previous slides, there are four different types of patents. Let's see what can be patented. Process or method, machine or apparatus, article of manufacture, composition of matter, including chemical compounds, physical mixtures, improvements of any of the above. So these are the different entities that may be patented. This is an example of a patent that was done by Diamond V. Chakravarti in the year 1918. The US Supreme Court established the rule that compositions of matter that are made by man, that is, that are not nature's handiwork, but the inventor's own, are patentable subject matter. AT&T Corp. versus Excel Communications in 1999 addressed patentability of computer algorithms as well. Is the claim subject matter as a whole a disembodied mathematical concept representing nothing more than a law of nature or an abstract idea? Or has the mathematical concept been reduced to some practical application rendering it useful? So you can understand that mathematical concept can also be patented so long it has been reduced to some practical application and it is in use. Other than that, the simple mathematical calculation or concept cannot be patented. If the algorithm as a whole produces a useful, concrete and tangible result and therefore is more than an abstract idea, then it is a subject matter of patent. Otherwise, a simple algorithm cannot be patented. This is a sample patent of United States. The patent number is given, the date of patent is given, applicant's name, inventor's name, and other necessary documents are also given. Number of claims, abstract, and in this patent, there are no drawings are shown. This is a sample image or drawing of a patent. For documenting inventions, first you keep a notebook. Keep the pages sequential and clearly dated. Write down your experiments, especially the ones showing structure of the invention and how to make the invention. This will produce reduction to practice. Also write down significant ideas that will lead to conception. Periodically show your notebook to someone else in the lab who is not an inventor but who has an obligation of confidentiality and can understand what you are telling them. Have that witness sign and date the pages and indicate that they have read and understood the content. US is the only first to invent country. Everyone else is first to file. An interference is a proceeding to determine who is first to invent. Evidence of invention date is usually from inventor's notebook. So in short, for documenting inventions, we should note down the following terms: notebook, pages, experiments, ideas, and timeliness. So NPEIT is a term which should be remembered before documenting inventions. We can have a loss of foreign patent rights. Let's see how. For a foreign patent, application must be filed prior to any disclosure of invention. So that means we cannot make any public disclosure in the form of speech or in the form of any journal paper or conference paper. Best way to do this is to use non-disclosure agreement. I would like to tell you here the best policy would be to file in US first, if possible, to preserve the foreign filing rights. Applicant then has 1 year period from the US application filing date to file in foreign countries. As per 35 US Code 101, whoever invents any new and useful process, machine, manufacture, or composition of matter, or any new and useful improvement thereof may obtain a patent, therefore. What are the requirements for patentability? Number one, useful. The patent must have some utility. It should achieve some objective. And it should not be against public policy. Next comes novelty. The patent must be new, that is different from prior art. Last but not the least, it should be non-obvious. That means the subject matter as a whole would not have been obvious at the time to person or ordinary skill in the art. These are the different parts of a US patent. Number A is specification, which gives the detailed description of invention and background. Number B is drawings, which gives the diagrams, flowcharts, data, for example, NMR, IR, etc. And number C is claims, which defines meters and bounds of invention. What are claims of a patent? The claims are basically similar to a fence around a piece of property. It defines the meters and bounds of a patent holder's property. See here, the claims of a patent define the scope of the invention. Let us look at this boundary. In the US peripheral, claiming is used. That is, the claim language defines the edge of the property, right? As per 35 US Code 112, first paragraph tells what description must be provided to support the scope of a claim. We should concentrate on structure of the invention, how to make the invention, how to use the invention, and what are the best modes possible for the invention. Prior art limits the scope of patent claims. The requirement for novelty of 35 US Code 102 means that a patent claim cannot include what is already in the prior art. Let us now look at a sample claim. We have to write like this: what is claimed is. Here, it claims a water gun. So the main embodiment is a water gun, and we will show here there are five different sub-embodiments of the water gun. So how do you write it? You write it like this: what is claimed is, in a water gun having a housing, a barrel, at least one pressurizable air-water storage tank, a pressurizing mechanism, a channel or release for shooting water, and a release mechanism, the improvement which comprises a controlled flow bursting water gun release mechanism, including a valve located within said channel, and so on, a first spring connected to said valve, and so on. C, a trigger connected to said housing, and so on. D, linkage connected to said trigger and to said valve, such that, and so on. E, a delay spring functioning as a part of said linkage, and so on. Infringement. Infringement is a term which is often used for a patent. Infringement of a patent occurs when a competitor makes, uses, sells, offers to sell, or imports an embodiment of the invention without the permission of the patent owner. There are several cases of patent infringement. If you search the internet, you would be able to find out such sample cases. Let us look at the diagrammatic representation of infringement. Let us see that this is a circle, which is an embodiment. This is a claim. Right. Now, let us look at the infringing embodiment. If any embodiment is found to be within the claim, then it is called an infringing embodiment. And if a claim is found outside the claim body or the boundary, then it is called non-infringing embodiment. We should be careful while writing the claims for your patent. If the patent falls within the boundary, then it will be infringing, otherwise not. The typical remedies for infringement are damages and injunction. When it comes to realizing the value of a patent, analyzing whether the technology that is currently used is vital to almost every available patent monetization option is very much important. For instance, the basic principle of determining whether a piece of technology is infringing a patent is to construe the patent claim for scope and meaning, and then compare the claim to the accused product to determine infringement. We understand that infringement of a patent claim requires that each and every claim element must be present in the accused product. So whether it is deciphering the claim or relying on knowledge of the industry, there is simply no substitute to have a person possessing ordinary skill in the art reading the claim and examining potential infringers. You can have a patent infringement test that will determine the meaning of the claim, that is the claim construction, apply meaning to the accused device, which basically has literal infringement or doctrine of equivalence infringement. Patent infringement must be proven by showing that the product or service infringes each and every element of the asserted claims. Specifically, demonstrating an alleged unpermitted use is a textual and graphical comparison of the claims and the potentially infringing use. You can even work with your patent attorney. You have to inform the attorney of whatever you know about the state of the art. You have to explain clearly what are the differences between your invention and the already existing state of the art. What parts of the structure of the invention you can change without affecting the way the invention is used. What changes can be made in the materials and methods for making the invention without affecting the structure? What are the key structural features that produce the result of the invention? These are the few points that you should understand and remember when working with your patent attorney. Previously, computer programs were not patentable. But today, computer programs are patentable. But they are patentable as a series of program process steps or a computer readable medium with the program process steps embedded in it. Business method patents. Methods of doing business, like business methods, are patentable so long as they produce a useful, tangible, and concrete result. Do not even need to be implemented in the software. So these are the two points to be understood when filing for business method patents. Is software patentable in Europe? The answer is no. Are software inventions patentable in Europe? The answer is yes, but there is a clause to it. It has to meet the necessary identity of a technical effect. Are business methods patentable in Europe? The answer is no. Is software patentable in the USA? The answer is yes. The acceptable software related inventions are computer aided design software, insurance and financial software systems, debuggers, operating systems, e-commerce solutions, compilers, business methods, etc. The non-acceptable inventions are mathematical laws, as explained earlier, for example, Fourier transform, Laplace transform, and the laws of nature. Processes based on these laws and implemented by computer programs are patentable, if new, useful, and non-obvious. So we can understand this mathematical laws or the laws of nature will be patentable so long you provide an application area to it. Otherwise, as simple mathematical law or laws of nature, they are not patentable. Are business methods patentable in the USA? The answer is yes, but you must understand some definite clause. Business method patents are highly scrutinized by the US examiners. They have a longer delays for granting the patents. And a very small percentage of US patents are actually business method patents. So understanding these facts, you must clearly make yourself understand whether you are going to apply for business method patents or not. International protection. The patent offices of the countries that are members to the PCT are called receiving offices. You cannot simply file an international patent application in any patent office, but rather you need to file in the appropriate receiving office. The Patent Cooperation Treaty or PCT assists applicants in seeking patent protection internationally for their inventions, helps patent officers with their patent granting decisions, and facilitates public access to a wealth of technical information relating to those inventions. By filing one international patent application under the PCT, applicants can simultaneously seek protection for an invention in any country. There is a difference between US and foreign patents. US patents only provide protection in the US for different products and processes made, used, sold, or offered for sale in the US and imports into the US. Foreign patents, on the other hand, must be obtained to provide protection for products and processes not made, used, offered for sale, sold, or imported in the US. Patent due diligence is a method of closely reviewing a patent portfolio and status. A strategy in technology development and patent portfolio management should include due diligence review. Such review would evaluate the intellectual property of others to gain freedom to operate in a given technology field. Due diligence helps investors and companies understand the nature of a deal, the risk involved, and whether the deal fits with their portfolio. Essentially, undergoing due diligence is like doing homework on a potential deal and is essential to inform about investment decisions. Now, why should you worry about it? There are huge damages to it. You can face lost profits, reasonable royalties, treble damages and attorney fees, price erosion, convoyed sales. You can also have disruption to business during litigation in the form of document production, depositions, significant issue affecting business. The cost of litigation. The cost to bring a patent case ranges from $750,000 to $1 million for a simple dispute and from $4 million to $8 million for a modest one. Monster cases can cost $10 million or more. This was provided in IP Worldwide, May 2002, page 43. How to conduct patent due diligence? You have to search or monitor. Patent searches on relevant product lines of primary competitors. Patent searches directed to the specific product being introduced. And you have to monitor relevant products being sold. You have to compare proposed new product or process to any relevant patents or competitor products. If necessary, you have to search for prior art. Here we come to the end of the patent lecture. Thank you very much for patient hearing. And if you want to know more about patents and intellectual property, you can contact me at this email address.